Welcome to the Vector Garden. In this tutorial, we're going to apply this text to this circle in a different way. Of course, you could use text on a path and then type this text. But maybe you want to distort this text slightly to adjust it better to that curve. What you can then do is use a brush. So let's go to the brushes panel. And what you would do is take this and drag this in here, make an art brush, and like this, and then you apply that. So I'm going to make a duplicate of this circle and apply that. And you see, well, this is maybe not what you want this to look like, because this gets really distorted and that's not the way it should be. How can we do that better and keep this width, but only apply it to the length it needs? And in order to do that, of course, we could measure this and then cut a portion of this path, but measuring that could get kind of complicated. So there's a different way. Now, first of all, this is still a circle, so we want this aligned to the bottom. So what we do here is cut it at the top. And of course, that one as well. So now it's cut at the top. And what we now need is the length of that path. So we go to Window Document Info. And in there, you need to set this to objects, which is already the case here. And you see it has 228.839 millimeters. So let's see that I can memorize that. And now I need to draw a box. And it needs to have that width. So let's go to the transform panel. Like this. And we have that same width. And let's drag that box up there. I'm going to get rid of that fill because I need to adjust the height as well. Like this. And then I'm going to take this here and put that one on top. But now, as you have seen before, Illustrator put this brush in the center of that stroke. I want it only at the bottom. So what I also need to do is make this twice as high. So let's go to transform again and let's just multiply this by 2. And let's just do it like this. So again, like so. Okay. And now I need to select them both and center this like so and just make a duplicate of it for the other one. But also now comes the important part. It needs to have a stroke and fill of none. And also, let's take a short look into the layers panel because we need to make sure there is actually no appearance applied, nothing, none at all. And then let's go to Object, Arrange, and bring this to the back. So now we can select both of them, go to the brushes panel again and drag it in there and make an art brush again, like so. This is how this should look like. This symbolizes the path and it's on the bottom. And now let's select that circle and apply that. And you see it's wrong, but we need to correct the path direction. So let's go to Object, Path, and reverse the direction. And there we have this. And of course, we can do it with that one as well. So let's select them both like this, just the box and the text. Center it, align them to the bottom, and then let's select it, set the stroke to none, and of course send this to the back, select them both, drag them in here and make another art brush like so, and again apply this and correct that direction. And you see, this works. Everything is well adjusted without the need of cutting something out of that circle.